we're just going to get started in child's pose. But before we do, I just want to say my name's Jade Ruiz. I am a yoga instructor here at Thrive Yoga and Wellness. And thank you for taking HIIT. We're going to start in child's pose. So we're going to press our foreheads into the mat. Extend our arms as far as we can. Put weight into your index finger and thumb. Breathe your ujjayi breath. That is the breath in and out through your nose. Maybe making the ocean sound, waves, or Darth Vader sound. Now throughout your practice, you're going to hear me cue pulling your belly button to spine. That is going to be your engaging your Uddiyana Bandhas. That is the pulling the up and in motion, pulling the belly button to spine, engaging your core. It's helping protect your back and build strength in your core as well. One more breath here. Hi, come on in. It's not hot, it's HIIT. But the next room is a beginner friendly, and it's also not heated. But this is the HIIT class, so it's the power class for the night. Mm-hmm. Yeah, come on in. Yeah, I love those leggings. No, it's HIIT. HIIT class, so it's high intensity yoga. Yeah, you'll love it. You'll love it. Is this your first class, I'm assuming? Your first class? Yeah, awesome. Well, nice to have you. Come on in. You'll need weights. They're in the hallway, but you can opt to not use them. Sounds good. Okay. No, there was this morning. We have heated tomorrow. You'll be sweating. This class will make you sweat. You won't need the heat. If I did this class in the heat, I'd probably pass out. You definitely create your own heat. No, don't be afraid. So my name's Jade. I'm an instructor here at Thrive Yoga and Wellness, and we're in HIIT class. This class is being streamed live on Facebook, and then we'll transfer over to their YouTube channel. You're not on it. It's just going to show, like, from my mat to the wall. So just letting you know. We're going to take... Vera, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Awesome. So we're going to start in child's pose. Throughout child's pose, we're going to engage those bandhas, pulling the belly button to spine motion, and work on your ujjayi breath throughout your practice. Now, throughout this practice, I can cue the weights. You can opt to not use them. That's fine, too. Also, throughout your practice, if you need to take a child's pose, feel free to do so. And now we're going to begin in tabletop. So that is wrists under shoulders, knees under hips. Okay. We're going to do a couple cat-cows. Inhale, look up. Exhale, roll your spine. Inhale, look up. And exhale, roll your spine. Maybe one more cat-cow. Good. Now we're going to do some balance reachers, which is you can grab the weight with your right hand. We're going to do some balance reachers, which is our right arm out and our left leg out. You can opt to puff up on those toes on the right here to help with balance. Thinking flat back, pull that belly button to spine, and we're going to do 10 reps of elbow to knee. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, a couple more, 9, 10. Hold that balance reacher out. Pull that belly button to spine. Engage your bandhas. Breathe your ujjayi breath. Release your weight and do one cat-cow. Inhale, look up. Exhale, roll the spine. Inhale, look up. And exhale, roll the spine. Grab your weight with your left hand. Come into balance reachers on the right. Left arm out, right leg out. Thinking flat back, wrist under shoulder. And 10 reps of elbow to knee. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Couple more. 9, 10. Hold that balance reacher out. Engage that core. One more breath. Release it. Let's do one cat-cow. Inhale, look up. Exhale, roll that spine. Awesome. Now here in tabletop, re-engage wrists under shoulders, knees under hips. We're going to do knee to chest. Shoot that knee back, keeping that knee bent, and then bring the knee to the underarm. And then again, knee to chest, shoot that foot back, and knee to underarm. Let's do 10 of these. 1, 2, 3. Coordination is not my strong suit. Shoot that back, underarm. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, shake out those wrists. Maybe take a child's pose if you're needing that right now. Very briefly. All right, coming back up to tabletop. Let's not lose that heat. On the left side, knee to chest, keeping that knee bent, shoot it back, and then knee to underarm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's a lot harder when you're trying to engage those bandhas, pulling that belly button to spine, everything up and in, and working on breath as well. So let's take one cat-cow. All right, now we're moving into threading the needle. So we're going to inhale, right arm up, high to the sky. Exhale, thread it through the left here, laying down on your cheek. Breathing your ujjayi breath in and out through your nose. Engage that core. Pull your belly button to spine. You want to soup this up a little bit? Bring your left leg out. Let's do 5 reps of knee to chest. And then shoot that leg back out. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Hold that leg out. Pull your belly button to spine. Engage those bandhas, releasing your knee back to the mat, slowly and mindfully coming out of that twist. Do one cat cow. Maybe wiggle around side to side. Okay. Now we're going to inhale. Left arm up, giving the wall a high five. Exhale, thread it through the right here. Breathing in and out through your nose. Being mindful of breath. Bringing your right leg out, working on balance and core. Good. Engage those bandhas. Five reps of knee to chest. One, shooting that leg back out. Two, balance challenge. Three, four, five. Hold that leg out. Breathe in and out. Releasing your knee to the mat, mindfully and slowly coming out of this twist. Feeling good? Awesome. All right, we're going to come to a forearm plank. Thinking flat back. Puffing up through in between your shoulders here. Holding this forearm plank. Pull that belly button to spine, working on core here and upper shoulder strength. Breathe your ujjayi breath. Now we're going to go to forearm plank. Push up to a high plank. Wrists under shoulders. Back down to forearm plank. Let's do five of these. On my count, one, two, three, four, one more, five. Good. All right, let's push to our first down dog of the day. Pedaling those feet back and forth. Your drishti, which is your gaze, should be down at your belly button. Pressing weight into your index and thumb. Releasing pressure off of your wrist. Pulling the belly button to spine and breathing your ujjayi breath. Good. Couple more breaths here. We're going to walk, step, or jump to a forward fold. Grabbing your weights if you'd like. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, look up and reach up. Sink into your chair. Chair, you want to have knees together, toes together. Sit in that imaginary chair. Moving your elbows, squeezing them into your ears, bringing your weights behind your head here, and pulsing those weights up and down, 10 reps. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Hold that chair. Sink a little lower. You can do this. Pull that belly button to spine. One more breath. Release your weights. Come back into your chair. And give me eagle legs and eagle arms. Balance is a challenge all on its own. Every day is different. Pull that belly button to spine. Focus on something very still. And be here on your mat. One more breath. Unwinding. Coming down to standing splits. Trying to get your hands as close to your left ankle as possible. Coming into that supreme balance. Maybe you grab your ankle with one hand, maybe both. Coming into curtsy lunges. We're going to exhale and bring that right leg, curtsy lunge behind the left. Get those tippy toes close to the bottom as possible. And then shoot your right leg back up straight in the air. Inhale, exhale, curtsy lunge. Shoot it back up. Let's do 8 curtsy lunges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2 more. We can do this. 7, 8. Bring your foot back to the mat into a forward fold. Step back. And take a vinyasa. Thinking chaturanga elbows stacked on top of your wrist. Inhale to up dog, exhale to down. Good job. All right, right leg shoots straight up in the air. Plant it in between your hands. And come up to Virabhadrasana 1. We want our hips square to the wall in front of you. Shoulders nice and relaxed. Pinkies gazed at one another. And our front knee bent at a 90 degree angle. You can opt your weights here if you'd like. And hold this warrior 1. Good. Breathing that ujjayi breath. Here in warrior 1, we're gonna bring our weights to our shoulders and back up together. 10 reps of these. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, we can do this, halfway there, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Windmill our hands down to the mat, step back and take a vinyasa. They can also be modified to your knee, chaturanga elbows. Coming up to up dog, rolling the toes down for down dog. Your drishti should be down at your belly button, pushing weight into your index and thumb, getting that pressure off of your wrist. Left leg shoots straight up in the air. Plant it in between your hands, grabbing your weights, if that's where you're at today. Coming up to warrior 1 on the left. I feel like this thing's coming off my head. I'm Madonna, guys. I need the combs. All right, so square hips. front knee bent at a 90-degree angle. Pinkies gazed at one another. Pull that belly button to spine. Breathe your ujjayi breath. We're going to do 10 reps, bringing our weights down to our shoulders and back overhead. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, almost there, 7, 8, 9, one more, 10. Windmill those hands to the mat. Take your vinyasa. Also can be modified by coming to your knees. Walk, jump, or step in between your hands, coming up to a forward fold. Get those weights ready. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, look up and reach up. Sink down into chair. The world's most favorite pose. Said no one ever. Just kidding. Okay. Sink a little lower here. Breathe that ujjayi breath. Squeeze those elbows into the ears. Drop your weights back behind you. Let's do 8 reps of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's drop those weights. Come back into chair. Pinkies gazed at one another. Your gaze is at the wall in front of you or up through your pinkies. All right, let's do eagle on the other side. So whichever side you did, you did. It's always easier. Balance on the other side than one. Also depends on the day. Focus on something still in front of you. Pull that belly button to spine. Breathe in and out through your nose. Be still and be here on your mat. One more breath. Unwind and come into standing splits. Trying to get that supreme balance, grab one ankle, maybe with one hand or both. Goal is trying to get your hands as close as you can to the right ankle. Pull the belly button to spine, and on that exhale, let's curtsy lunge on the right. Shoot it back up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, one more, 10. Woo, come into down dog. Breathe your ujjayi breath in and out through your nose. Cannot keep my shirt down. Your drishti is towards your belly button. We're going to jump, walk, or step to a malasana squat, getting those heels at the corner of the mat. We good? All right. So here in our malasana squat, we're going to press our elbows into the inner thighs, opening up our hips, hands at heart center. Pulling that belly button to spine. Engaging the bandhas, pulling everything up and in. I need to go to a class on just breathing and bandhas alone, because it's hard. All right, so pressing those hands into the mat, we can work on crow, play with crow. That's shimmying those knees into those underarms, pressing your weight into your hands, lifting 1, maybe 2 feet. When you got that, let's shoot into a vinyasa. Good. And at the very least, just play with it. Go to your edge. Maybe try crow again. See if you can get a little higher. Awesome. Good crow. You got it. You can do it. You can do it. Good job, guys. And just breathing through your vinyasa. We're going to come to, when you're ready, take a quick little child's pose. Kind of catch your breath. Take a water break. Pressing your forehead into the mat. Coming into a high plank when you're ready. You can opt for your weights on this one as well. Thinking high plank, wrists under shoulders, puffing up in between your shoulders here. Engaging those bandhas, pulling everything up and in, belly button to spine. Let's shift over to side plank on the right. So getting that weight available to you with your left hand. Setting up for side plank on the right. Modifying can be coming to your knee here. Side plank on the right. Let's try to bring our knee to elbow here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold that high plank. Whew. Shaky knees. Let's thread that needle through the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let it go. High plank. Child's pose. Breathe it out. In and out through your nose. You don't have to go to my count. You can go to your own edge, whatever feels good to you. There's no pain, no gain in yoga. All right, everyone's ready. Let's get to high plank again. Engaging those bandhas again. Let's shift for high plank on the left. You can modify this and come to that knee. Good. So in this modified version, let's bring our elbow to knee. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do a few more. 6. We can do it. 7, 8. All right. Back to high plank on that left. All right, let's thread through the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold that high plank. You got this. One more breath. Release that weight. Come back to center high plank. Take a vinyasa. In down dog, let's pedal those feet back and forth. Let's bring our right leg up. Shoot it straight up in the air. Uh-oh. Lost my head here. Let's bring that right knee to nose. Get those tippy toes as close as you can. And shoot it straight back. Shoot the legs straight back high in the air. And again, 1, 2, 3, 4. Your drishti is at your belly button. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10. You can take a child's pose if you need to. That cool down period. The good thing about HIIT, we have our high intensity periods, we also have our cool down periods. So it's not just one long stream of dying in a good way. Awesome. So when you're ready, let's go back to down dog and we will work that other side out. Your drishti is at your belly button. Engage those bandhas. Sink back with your ujjayi breath. Shoot your left leg straight up in the air. Get that knee to nose, tippy toes as close as you can, and shoot the leg straight back. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Two more, 9, 10, down dog. Okay, right leg forward, come up to crescent lunge on the right. We can get those weights handy if you'd like. Always use them when and if you're ready. Crescent lunge on the right here. Hands at heart center. You can twist open if you've got those weights. Twist to the right. Maybe with each exhale, twist a little deeper. Good. Couple more breaths. Hmm. releasing those weights, if you have them, bring your hands to heart center. And let's twist on the right. Left elbow to right knee. Getting those hands, prayer hands at heart center. Breathing in this twist here, pulling that belly button to spine, helping you get a little deeper in your twist. Let's plant the left hand on the outside of the right foot. Shoot the right hand high to the sky, grabbing that imaginary rope. Maybe we're staying here. Maybe we want to try to come up on that left leg and balance here. And letting that down, coming back up to crescent lunge, grabbing your weights, back up to crescent lunge. Open up to warrior two, so that back foot needs to be parallel to the back of the mat. Hips square to the wall in front of you. And your drishti is through your middle finger. Flip the front hands up. Come back for peaceful warrior. Don't drop the weight on your face. That would not be good. Keeping that front knee bent. And forearm to thigh. Left hand reaches overhead for extended side angle. Your chest needs to be square to the wall in front of you. So maybe puff up through your ribs. Left rib. Thinking little to no weight on your thigh. So maybe you want to hold a tray or a beach ball. And windmill the hands down to the mat. Step back. Stay in high plank. Flat back, puffing up in between your shoulders. We are going to bring our right foot right behind your right wrist. And we're going to do mountain climbers towards our right wrist. So one, two, one, two, one, two. Keep going. Stop. Come back to high plank. Let's take a child's pose. All right, guys, when you're ready, let's come back to that high plank. Bring your left foot to the left wrist. And we're going to do some mountain climbers towards that left wrist. So switch kick back and forth. One, two, one, two, one, two. Keep going. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, back to high plank. Flat back. Hold that high plank. Okay, let's take a vinyasa. Coming to the knees is an option. Meeting in down dog is an option. Left leg shoots straight up in the air. Plant it in between your hands. And come up to crescent lunge on the left. Whew. This class does not need to be heated. I know you guys can tell that. But our other friends on the other side of the screen cannot tell. Unless you see me drenched. This class definitely creates your own heat, and you will definitely sweat out all of those toxins. I'm breathing like a cow. In and out through your nose. crescent lunge on the left. Hands at heart center, twist to the left, right elbow to left knee. It's so much harder on one side. A modification for this pose, for those of you that don't know, is a block right here for when we come into reverse. So planting our hand on the outside of that left foot. So modification. Maybe you want to stay here. Maybe you want to try to balance and come up on that right foot. Woo! That side's not having it. Maybe you just want to do some toe taps. If balancing on that left foot is not happening today. Good. Okay. Come back up to crescent lunge. Good. Open up to warrior two. So back foot parallel to the back of the mat. Re-engage those hips. Square to the wall in front of you. Front knee is bent at a 90 degree angle. Good. Flip the front hand up, reach it overhead for a peaceful warrior. And forearm to thigh, reach overhead for extended side angle. Thinking little to no weight on that thigh. Maybe you want to reach underneath and take a bind. You can. And unwinding this bind, windmill your hands to the mat. Get ready for a high plank. Puff up between your shoulders. Think flat back, wrists under shoulders. And let's just do some center mountain climbers. So right foot in the center here, and switch feet. Let's do 10 sets of these guys. One. You're good. And a child's pose. Woo! Hallelujah. Cool down time never felt so good. Okay. Awesome. Okay. I have one more set of high planks, and I swear I'm done with them. But they're good. They're good for you. They're like total whole body workout. Okay, high plank, guys. You got it in you. I know you do. So wrists under shoulders. Flat back. We're going to crisscross toe taps. And then jump into that Malasana squat. Plant those hands back to the mat. Jump back to high plank. Crisscross those toes. Malasana squat. Total body workout. Working on balance and core. Looking good. To do five or more. You can do it. Good. You can take a child's pose if you want. or water break. Okay. It's hump day. Halfway to the weekend. Any lake plans? Yeah. Oh, really? Nice. Congratulations. Oh, no. Gotta weigh out the options. You do? Awesome. Okay, high plank again. Last one. I promise. You guys are rock stars. Puff up through those shoulders. We're gonna right knee in, set it back, both legs out. Back to high plank, left knee in, set it back, both legs out. Back to high plank, right knee in, set it back, both legs out. And again, left side, right side, left side. One more time, right side. One more time, left side. Whew. Child's pose. Good. Good, good, good. Is it just me, or does today feel like a lot harder? I know. It's so hot. I couldn't imagine doing this class in the heat. Okay. All right, guys, down dog, right leg in between your hands. Come up to crescent lunge on the right. Oh, there we go. And again, you can always opt in to using those weights. Totally your choice. Let's revolve this twist. Twist to the right. Hold it. Keep that knee bent. Good. Exhale, twist a little deeper. Breathe through your nose, in and out. Your ujjayi breath. Pull your belly button to spine. Everything up and in. Twist. Peaceful warrior. So revolve this peaceful. So we're in the twist. Left arm reaches overhead. Right arm sits on your sacrum here. And turn this around to warrior two. Straighten the front leg, shoot your hips back, lean forward, and come into triangle pose. Thinking, standing in between two panes of glass. So maybe puff up through those ribs. One line of energy. Pull your belly button to spine and breathe. And rotate your right foot forward. Roll up to a five-pointed star, giving the wall a high five. Good. Inhale. Clasp your hands behind your back. Rotate your shoulders back and forward fold, using slow with control, using your abs. Dropping your hands to the mat. Take a little wider step and come into a wide-legged forward fold. Maybe sway back and forth, do some lunge stretches, whatever feels good to you. This is your practice. Make it your own. Maybe you want to practice some inversion play, headstand, tripod, handstand on the wall, whatever feels good to you. When you're done playing, you can roll up one vertebrae at a time. But this is your inversion play, so feel free to practice on anything you want to practice on. You can use the wall, handstand on the wall, tripod. You want to do a supportive headstand? Yeah. Yeah, supportive headstand. So in supportive headstand, you're going to want to clasp your hands to show you the distance you need to have. Clasp your hands together. Put your forehead, the center of your head, gently onto the mat. Come up into a little egg. Yep, and kick up. Oh my God, that was so good. That was so good. You did good. Just tightening that core, pulling that belly button to spine, and helping yourself float up, and just focusing on like piking down. Nice and slow. Nice and slow. Kind of work yourself up into an egg. Good. Yep. You're good? That's amazing that you can do that. That is, you're so open. Oh my God, that is amazing. Try the tripod. No, you're good. You're super strong. Try tripod. You did. That was the, let's see. You're here. Yeah, and you come up. Yes, yeah, so and move your elbows in a little more. Yep. And then, yep, put your knees on, try to get them up a little more. And pull your belly button to spine and try to float, gravitate up using that core. Yeah. You're so open in your shoulders. It's unreal. That's amazing. I'm so tight in my shoulders. No, you're strong. You're good. That is awesome. That is unbelievable. Yeah, so, okay, look at my elbows here. So you're in this egg, and then you push your weight into the mat, pull your belly button to spine, and just gravitate your legs up. So, yeah, and get your knees on that, yep, on the forearm there. Up underneath, yep. Push your weight into the mat. There you go. There you go. Now focus on holding it. Yeah. You're good. You just have to hold it. You just have to hold it. Yeah. You hold it with your core. And that's your Uddiyana Bandhas. That is why it is so important throughout your whole practice of pulling your belly button to spine, tighten that core, engage those bandhas, pull everything up and in, and you're building muscles inside and out. And with that, I mean, that really helps you float into crow, headstand, shoulder stand, everything. I mean, core is key. Yeah. You guys are good, though. Y'all are rock stars. You're so, like, that is my shoulder goal. It's to be that open in my shoulders. You're just naturally like super flexible in your and open in your shoulders. That's awesome. You're just building all kinds of strength. You don't even know it. Good job. Oh my gosh, that is awesome. Yes. Good job. Yay! But I can also, you can't. That is amazing, though. Kicking into wheel. That's awesome. Good job, guys. Yay. I love classes like this. Okay. Let's see. Where are we? We didn't do the other side, did we? Okay. All right. Let's do crescent lunge on the left, and we'll just work that other side out. Okay. Good. Revolve this, twist, and with every exhale, twist a little deeper. Right hand goes up, high to the sky, revolve peaceful, and open up to warrior two. Good. Squaring those hips, good job. Straighten that left leg. Shoot your hips back, lean forward, and come down for triangle pose. Thinking about standing in between two panes of glass, one line of energy, puffing up right here through the ribs. Pull that belly button to spine. Breathe in and out through your nose. Rotate the left foot forward. Roll up to five-pointed star, giving the wall a high five. Let's go ahead and grab those weights. Come back up to five-pointed star. Okay. Bend those knees for goddess and bring the weights down to your shoulders. Elbows together, back out and up. Shoulders, elbows together, back out and overhead, and again. Let's do 10 sets of these. Good. Hold it when you're done. Come up on your tippy toes in a goddess squat. Woo. Good. Shake your knees. All right, release that. Whew. Let's come down to seated. Today was harder. Harder than most days. That means I get to go home and eat ice cream. Okay, awesome. Okay, let's come up to boat. So get your weights next to you. Boat can be here. It can be here, here, or here. We need to think legs out, chest out. You can grab on the inner thighs. Pull your chest up and your legs up. Re-engage with those weights. And let's row our boat. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Hold that boat. You got this. All right, let's sink low, low, low to canoe. And back up to boat. One more time, low, 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 slow, slow, slow to canoe. And back up to boat. Oh. Okay, release that. Shake out those legs. Come to your back. Feet to the mat. Get your pinky tips, your fingertips, to your heel, clasp your hands underneath your sacrum, shimmy those shoulders toward one another, and lift up for bridge. Good. Shimmy those shoulders close as you can. When you're ready, release that bridge. Okay. And get ready for shoulder stand. Good. Flat on your back. Getting your hands at your sacrum. Walking those elbows close to one another. Pushing your hands on your sacrum. Thinking about getting your knees stacked with your hips, stacked with your shoulders. Thinking one line of energy here. Leaving room between your chin and your neck. And your gaze is up through your toes to the ceiling, not side to side. And when you're ready, drop your feet behind your head here for plow. Clasping your hands to the mat. And when you're ready, release to the mat. Coming into fish, which is a nice little counteractive pose, little heart opener. So make that diamond shaped at your sacrum here. And walk those elbows in toward one another and drop your neck back. Nice little heart opener. Soup this up, lift your feet up, point them out. Doing some heart opening, lower ab work. Release that down to the mat and go all the way down for your Shavasana. Okay. All right. Guys, thank you so much for tuning in to my Wednesday 6:30 HIIT class. My name is Jade Ruiz, and this is Thrive Yoga and Wellness. Hope you guys enjoyed. Okay.